might as well start behind. There's much more going on up there than anywhere.
Yeah. We won't be able to get that far.
Got on the beach as well. Fine.
Thank you. Samai, everybody. Welcome to Peel on the Isle of Man. This is the year of our island, 2018. Tonight we celebrate Voaldyn, which means May Eve in the Manx language. A special time of the year in the Manx calendar. A time where we say goodbye to winter and embrace summer. A time to cast off the darkness and celebrate the light. Our festival is a living, dynamic reinterpretation of an ancient Celtic and Norse ritual, bringing people together to acknowledge and revel in the birth of the summer and the fertility of the land. The purpose of our festival is not to recreate ancient, but to continue in the spirit of our ancient forebears and create our own connection and cycles. Special place. Look around you. Look to the surrounding hills, the majestic fortress of the kings of Man and the Irish Sea, protected by Manannan's mist. Over thousands of years on this very spot, it's been host to hunter-gatherers, people from the Iron Age, early Christians, Vikings, smugglers, and fishermen. Look out from the shadows for the past. For the next 50 minutes, enjoy the sights and sounds of Voaldyn. In days gone by, local traditions and customs played an important part in people's lives, as they still do to this day. Traditions that were interwoven with the need to survive and the changing seasons of the farming calendar. At the onset of summer, the folk set fire to the gorse on the hills, and our ancestors believed that the gorse was the hiding place of witches and fairies. Of course, burning the gorse also cleared the land ready for planting. The island has seen many peaceful settlers coming to the shore, including the first Christians who arrived here in flourished. Monasteries and fields were built around the island, including on the battered isle which we see in front of us. In 798 AD, this peace came to abrupt end with the unwelcome arrival of the marauding Vikings. They landed on this very beach here in the field, and after ransacking the monastery on St. Patrick's Isle, they ravaged the rest of the island. For the next 100 years, they attacked Manx, finally settling and claiming the island for their own. Hundreds of years later, in more peaceful times, the Celtic and Norse traditions have been fused to celebrate E. Voaldyn, remembering the past the neighbouring villages and farms would hold, mock battles between winter and summer, which could go on for days. Welcome to the shore, the Queen of Winter and her army, here to battle it out this summer. Thank you.
summon.
In the gayest and best manner they have, and is attended by her many maids of honour. She has a young man who is her captain, who had under his command a good number of foot soldiers. In her opposition, the Queen of Winter, dressed in woollen hoods, furs, and laden with the warmest and heaviest habits. She also has a number of attendants, nor is she without a captain and troop for her defence. Representing the beauty of the spring and the deformity of the winter, they set forth from their respective quarters, the one preceded by violins and flutes, the other with the rough music of the tongs and cleavers.
Flowers on their heads.
The beach, the May Queen with her colourful troops ready for battle. As summer and winter get ready for a scuffle. Insults are to be exchanged, and the queens decorate their champion. Both sides are eager to win.
Tum se ya ye dil sa ya ya. Tum se ya ye dil
So now we see the champions each take up arms in defense of their queen. These battle-hardened warriors have spent the winter honing their skills in preparation for tonight's fight. Which side do you want to win? Is it going to be summer. Or winter? In Viking time, the feud was settled by Hongdang, which were a fight to the death. Thank you.
Yeah, film boat waiting.
Traditionally, it's been Voaldyn, rowan twigs were fashioned into a sort of a cross, wound with wool, called a cross curd. These charms, often made by men and boys, were believed to ward off bad luck and evil spirits. They were placed at the entrance of homes, in the cowshed doorways, and hidden on board fishing boats. It was customary to tie a cross churn to the tails of the animals, and then dry them through the smoke of the fires, to cleanse and protect them from evil before they put out into the fields.
When she brings the seeds of the harvest of the barley and the tempo, and she knows when we'll go to our graves and how we shall be born. Once a sorrow, the tears of joy, please for her and falls to the ground.
Thank you.
Trees celebrate all religions and all beliefs. In Viking times, Yggdrasil was the Viking tree of life, and it is an eternal green ash tree. It is located in the middle of Asgard, and where the Viking gods live. Its branches stretch out over all the nine worlds in Viking mythology. The trees being burnt tonight bear messages of hope and love, and remember those that have departed and those that are yet to come. Thank you. Please welcome Stacey Astor, Manx Bard, to read her new poem called Voaldyn.
The long days are at us, and the nights they're drawing back. There's no time for tread or work, but it comes to butcher us. The Voaldyn is approaching, and them ones will be near. So be sure that your first turn hangs with all. That you hold dear. Take two branches of the fir. There's no metal to be used. Put the sheep wool in their hedges and bind till frost is fused. May flowers need to rise around each and every doer. Don't you forget in the cowhouse. Make all you care for secure. Take your maypings for a fire at the top of nearby hill. Light it up and drifting smoke will purify all ill. All night the bells will be ringing to scare themselves away. So make sure that you pay mind and stay safe on all May Day.
Fireworks commence. You can come forward and get a blessing from the main square.